It has been a year since a drunk driving accident in Monterey left a teen partially paralyzed, another facing prison time. Chelsie Hill has been rebuilding her life since then, since that February 21st crash. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong spoke with her. She is live in our Salinas newsroom with an update.
Dan, the interview began with tears but ended with laughs. We spoke with Chelsie about everything, including how she feels about the drunk driver, Aaron Korn. We also spoke with Chelsie's best friend, who we found out offered Chelsie a ride home that night, a ride that could have changed everything.
I don't know, it's hard because I don't know.
It's the anniversary no one wanted, least of all, Chelsie Hill.
All the pain that I went through, like, in the hospital, like, comes back to me.
After a party on February 21st, 2010, Chelsie and four Pacific Grove High School friends got into an SUV with a drunk driver behind the wheel. Minutes later, the teens crashed into a tree off Holman Highway. Chelsie admits she made a mistake.
I'll never get in the car with someone who's been drinking. Ever again. I have a lifetime sentence now because of that one decision we all made.
A decision not only she regrets. The driver, 19-year-old Aaron Korn, may spend nearly a decade in prison. Chelsie hasn't seen him since the accident.
Eventually, I would like to see Aaron, but right now, I don't know if I'm ready. I know it's hard for him, too.
It's also been tough for Chelsie's best friend, Karina Bernier, who had dropped her off at the party.
If you guys need a ride later on, I'll come pick you up. You know, I specifically remember saying that because I was like, wait, who's driving tonight? I don't see any cars.
Chelsie didn't make that call. She ended up spending 51 days in the hospital, paralyzed from the waist down, a painful time for her father, John.
Sometimes I wake up in the middle of the night and I feel that rush of pain. It's something that I don't think I could live through again. I wouldn't want anybody to, because it's like every molecule in your body explodes at one time.
John and Chelsie have healed together, even getting tattoos. His reads Chelsie's journey. Hers says faith.
I have faith in my feet and my legs that, you know, one day everything will be okay.
Despite all the frustration, the tears and what-ifs, Chelsie is smiling more than ever before. She's been learning how to walk again, is driving on her own with hand controls, and has joined the Colors in Motion dance team.
I'm dancing again. I'm driving again. I'm hanging out with my friends. I'm being me, you know, and that's what matters, is I'm still me and I'm still all here.
A very strong girl. Now, Chelsie has also spoken to thousands of students about the dangers of drunk driving. And she and her father have created a foundation called Walk and Roll, dedicated to families, to people who suffered spinal cord injuries. They're trying to raise enough money to bring a program called Project Walk up here to the Monterey Bay area, so people don't have to drive all the way down to Southern California for that physical therapy program. Dan.
All right. Thank you, Stephanie. The driver in the accident, Aaron Korn, pleaded no contest to drunk driving and auto theft charges in January. He'll be sentenced later this month. He's facing up to 9 years in prison. If he gets felony probation, he could theoretically walk out of jail a free man.